Hello everyone, and welcome back to Animes by FaceRig. How much fun could you have joining a meeting or a video conference as Donald Trump? Well, you probably could have some fun, and I'm going to show you how to do it. So for this video, our tool of choice for video conferencing is going to be Google Meet. So this is how to use Animes with Google Meet. Animes is available on Steam and is the successor to the very successful FaceRig program, which also replaced your face with that of a comedy or animated avatar. FaceRig is free to use, and as a result of which, you can get in there straight away. If you are a FaceRig owner, then there is currently a discount that will be available to Animes users off subscription services. Now inject a little bit of fun into your meetings or your distance learning if you're in school or in having distance learning classes. So Animes by FaceRig can do this with a multitude of meeting programs such as Microsoft Teams, Google Meet, Cisco WebEx, Cisco WebEx Teams, the list goes on, BlueJeans. But how do you do it? So with Animes, you get a number of avatars. Some avatars you have to pay for, some avatars come free. So how do you configure your avatar with size on the screen, props and things like that, where you can inject a little bit of fun into your meetings? So at the beginning, what we said was we would set our avatar for Donald Trump. Donald Trump is a paid avatar for 399 coins, and you can buy coins by clicking on that item. There's obviously a subscription as well. You can buy coin packs, and there's a subscription and dollar amount there as well to supercharge your experience. But enough of that. I've already bought the Donald Trump avatar. There it is. We're going to select that. You click on confirm, and then Animes loads that character in. Here it comes. And there he is. A caricature or avatar of Donald Trump. And certainly no disrespect is made or intended. So here we go. We've confirmed that. Let's close that down. We can see that my face is being tracked with the dots around my jawline, around my mouth, my nose, and my eyes as well. So that's exactly what the computer is seeing. If for any reason you're having problems and the avatar is not operating as normal, click on calibrate or press Control and C. Clicking on calibrate brings up this screen again. It's picking up the dots around my facial features. Look directly at your webcam or iOS device, click calibrate, neutral expression, good calibration, and your avatar should resolve any issues that it has. Now, with your mouse, if using this on a PC, you can use the mouse wheel to enlarge or shrink your avatar. Okay, now you can also hold the shift key down and move around a background if it's an anime's background. Holding the control key down, you can rotate your avatar as well. There we have the back of the avatar's head. You can scroll it up, make it larger, but not too large. Bit of a scary thought. Let's move it to that's a decent size, I think. And there's our avatar to the side. And you can rotate it a little bit more. You can also move him by right-clicking the mouse and holding the control key down to different sides of the screen. Okay, great. So let's put a prop on our avatar's head. There we go, we've got our prop. Click on props, and there's a range of props that the FaceRig and Animes team have included. So, you know, you could have, for example, a jester's hat, you could have a crown, a cowboy hat, even a beer hat as well. Now if these don't fit your avatar just right, then select one perhaps that might well do. There's a winged helmet that doesn't really fit our avatar well, but hey, the headphones actually do. So selecting the headphones, there we go. What we want to do is now size them perfectly for our avatar. So there's our avatar, right? Clicking on advanced, you can move them around different positioning if they're not quite right, you know, on the model. Again, you can do the sizing as well. Move them backwards or forwards along the x-axis. That might fit a little bit better and not detract really from what you want, which is basically your avatar's mouth. Okay, so that basically was how to change your avatar, put a prop on its head, and make yourself look like Donald Trump in a meeting. But how do you get this into a meeting program of choice? Well, I'll show you. It's all about this button at the bottom here called Broadcast. This button will allow you to send this image to a meeting package of choice, like Google Meet, for example, Zoom, you know, the list goes on, Cisco WebEx, BlueJeans, Microsoft Teams. The broadcast function, think of it this way. You have your webcam, you have your meeting application. NMA sits in the middle. So we have to have the input, as we can see here, as you can see my real life input on the left-hand side of the screen. We'll then go into Animes, then get translated to the avatar of choice. In this case, we've got a caricature of a gentleman. And then that will then get sent to the meeting program. As a result, then you have to press the broadcast button. Once you start broadcasting, you get a countdown of 90 minutes. There you go. And then that will then go into your meeting application of choice. A lot of people forget this step, and it's imperative to be broadcasting, else you'll get a black screen in your meeting application as well. So here we are in our meeting application of choice, which happens to be Google Meet. So we're going to take our Animes avatar and use it in a Google Meet meeting. Couldn't be easier. We can do it a couple of ways. Look at the cog, top right hand side, the settings. Bring that up. Look at video. Use the down arrow button. And look for Animes virtual camera. Now you can see I've got a couple of cameras in there because I've been doing different products on the meeting applications. But Animes virtual camera is what you want. Select that. That camera will say it's starting. Then you want to go into our Animes desktop and make sure you're broadcasting. Select broadcast. You'll see the 90 minute countdown timer is going to be there. All right, if you need to calibrate, now's the time to calibrate. Look directly into the center of the screen, click calibrate. You're done, you're broadcasting. Right, back into Google Meet, and you can see that where my face should be, I've got my fox, I've got my Animes avatar. You can close that down. Let's go to new meeting, start an instant meeting. Everything starts. We've set our settings. And there we are. Now, Google Meet recently released a feature where you could change the background, much like Zoom and other products, without using a third-party application. As a result of which, you can get some varying effects as well, depending on what you're doing. Now, this is my background that I've used on Animes. All right, that's come through. Or I can use some of the backgrounds as well that come through with Google Meet, or some of the backgrounds that I can use from Animes. So I can put our fox, for example, I don't know, in a field. That's where foxes are, right? They're in fields. So couldn't be easier than that. What you see in Animes is translated to what we see in Google Meet. You can join your meeting and away you go. Start your camera. And then when your camera starts, it'll translate and it'll show you exactly what's going on from Animes. And here you have it. There you go. Couldn't be easier. Now, to stop this, it's a little bit more complicated. So if you're getting some grief, for example, your colleagues don't like it, you're getting told off by your teacher, don't worry. Turn off your camera. All right. Then you go to the three dots, more options at the bottom. Settings. Go to video. Select your web camera, in which case then the Microsoft Live camera. Go to Animes, stop broadcasting, Okay. You may have to close the anime's application down, so we'll do that just to be sure. And then, once satisfied, you should be able to turn your camera back on and it show your web camera feed. This is because nothing else should be using your webcam. There you go. We see that Chrome, my Norton LifeLock is accessing it. And there I am on screen with my background, my busy background blurred. So that's how you put it on, and that's how you take it off. That's how you use animes, that's how you stop using animes and go back to your standard webcam within Google Meet. So what have we seen in this meeting? We've seen how to select an avatar. From that avatar, we've then put a prop on them. We've then changed avatars, we've changed backgrounds, and we've put all of that into a popular video conferencing tool that I'm sure we've all used sometime, Google Meet. And that's how you use animes with Google Meet. Thanks very much for watching. Like and subscribe if you haven't already done so. Check out for more videos in this series, not only on animes, we've got old videos on Face Rig as well, and how to have other fun with these sets of tools with other video conferencing applications. Thanks for watching. See you soon.